Hello beautiful people, thank you for joining us again today. In today's video, I'll show you how you can populate Mattable from an API. Today's video, we will be using this API service. Is a list of countries. I also did a video about how you can fetch countries and fetch state and fetch cities. If you can add that to your form, you can check out that video. The link is added somewhere here in this video. So we have the regular Angular material table with demo data, which is what you have. But today we will just replace those data. We have this demo data here. Today we'll be replacing this data with an API call from that API service. If today's your first time watching our videos, thank you so much. Please don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so you can always get notified when we upload a new video. And also leave us a comment. Let us know what you think about the video. It helps us to do better, right? Hit the like button if you like the video. Okay, without further delays, let's get to it. So as you can see, I already have this demo data from Angular Material site. It's just all of this. I have also created the service we're going to use to consume the API. I also have a model country. There's nothing inside of it. We're going to fill it together. This is going to hold the countries when I fetch them. I also made a video detailed with about making API calls. So if you're feeling overwhelmed, you can just check out that video. It's a lot more in detail. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is go to the country, the API, and then read the documentation. For this one, it requires you to have, this is the API, the endpoint you need to call, and then it requires some key, which I already have, keys to heaven. Okay, joking. All right, and this is what we're expecting, an ID, name, and ISO2. So this I'm gonna create in the model. Alright, so I have created the model for the country. The next thing is to actually make the API call and then replace the data, place the dummy data with the data we fetch from the API. So let's go ahead. For us to make API calls, we need to import a particular module, which is the HTTP client module, into our app module and then use it. So I'm just going to grab that. Because this particular API request requires authentication, I'm gonna start by creating that authentication in the header so that I can always append that to the calls that I make. Okay, I can do that. First of all, in the constructor, I'm gonna get that API HTTP client service. This is me trying to get the authentication, the header, so that whenever I make the call, I can just call this header. Then I'm gonna grab my access token, my access key, and I'm gonna put it inside here. Okay, so now we have our HTTP header. So this header again is to authenticate us when we make the call. All right, let's proceed. Now we call that model country. Here I'm gonna paste the URL. Then in our app component, the TS, I'm gonna create a variable first. Okay, I'm gonna import the service in my app component module. Okay, so before I begin, I need to create a constructor. I forgot to do that. Here, Okay. Now we console load this just so that we can see if that API call is working before we replace the demo data with the API call data. Okay, let's go check that out. So when I reload the page, reloaded, and then I try to check inspect it, and I go to console. Oh no, we have not started running this that call. I need to add it to ng on init. So I'm gonna put it here so that on page load it's gonna fetch the country. Okay, so I see that I made a mistake in the key. That's why we're getting unauthorized. The access key, there is a mistake there. I'm going to correct it right away. So I'm just going to show you what the mistake is that I did, that I made. So you look at this key, right? This was not included in the key, right? So I'm just going to replace that. Okay, let's try again. So now I have 250 countries, which is the first step. So I've got all the countries now. The next step is to replace and display those countries in the table. The next thing is to replace this dummy data. To replace this dummy data with the data that is coming from the API. That is what we're gonna do next. All right, so to do that, the first thing that I want to do is to get to replacing from the HTML. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4 columns, but from our result I have only 3 columns, which is ID, name and ISO2. So I'm gonna start from the HTML. So I'm gonna replace the column definition an element with those IDs. Now this is just like saying for each, right? So we're saying let element. So if I go to my country, to the country.ts file, I see I have an ID, I have name and I have ISO2. I'm just gonna replace that. So the first column. Now, why would we need to do this? So you see column definition here. We need to replace it with the columns that are going to come in and replace it. So here we have 4. I'm going to reduce that to 3. I'm going to take this one away. And this is going to be ID, is the ID as it is in the API and in the model. So this will be ISO2. And this is exactly the same I'll change in the HTML file. Now for our API service doesn't have the fourth content, so I'm just gonna get rid of this. Right now we have made these changes, but we have not changed or loaded data into the data source. So if we look at our screen, we're gonna have so this is only displaying name because it's the same thing, and this is still calling from the static data. So we're gonna change that. So here that we fetch the country, we're gonna load the countries that we've got in here into this data source. So I'm gonna redeclare data source on top and then load data source inside this fetch country. So I'm going to comment out all of this one up until here. Just going to comment this one out since I don't need it anymore. And I'm going to get rid of all of this. Get rid of it. All right, so we're getting lots of errors. That's okay. On top here, I'm going to declare data source, and this I'm going to make it end. And then just after we loaded this data into this country, this will be new math table, data source, and then we're going to pass this list countries to it. So I'm going to pass that. Okay, so now if we save, we're getting all the countries. It's about 200 and something. It's a long, long list of countries, 250. So this is how you load, you populate math table from an API call. All right, so if you find this content useful, please consider subscribing, hit the like button, and leave us a comment. And don't forget to share, like, and if you're feeling generous, you can buy me a coffee using the link top there. The link will also be in the description. You don't have to buy me coffees. You can just subscribe and you can just like. Any of those actions equals coffee to me. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.